here is a screenshot. Good old Steven Anderson's back. But this is Anderson's demonstration that there is a textual variant in the Greek Septuagint at Hosea 11:1 that everybody already knew there was one. When I say everyone, I mean everyone who would be interested as to whether there are textual variants in the Greek Septuagint, which of course there are. There are lots of them. And in fact, I've found it really interesting to preach from the Septuagint. Because when I preach from the Greek Septuagint, especially if you're preaching from a text you know, when I taught the Isaiah 6 passage, I used those two beautiful Jeffrey Rice rebinds of the Greek Septuagint to preach from Genesis and Isaiah a few weeks ago at church. And when you look at it, there's almost no passage that you could possibly run into. Are you not going to find some variation between the Greek Septuagint and the Hebrew text that we have today, which is, in general, the Biblia Hebraica Septuagintensia is the Masoretic text with one S. I spelled it with two S's in something recently. And then the Greek Septuagint. There's lots of variations. And so what he does is he goes through the Hebrew and points out that this is, you know, Mitzrayim is Egypt, prefixed min. The nu has been assimilated here. You can see that with the form of the second mem there. And so out of Egypt, and let me move an arm here. Yeah, there it is. Kara, to call, I have called my son, my son. So this is the messianic prophecy found in Hosea 11:1. And then when it's quoted in the New Testament, notice it says, Ekala Satan Huyan Mu, called my son. But in the Septuagint that he is citing, he has metakalasa ta tekna autu. So in the, and he didn't identify, at least not that I heard. Maybe he didn't, I missed it. But he didn't identify what Septuagint he was utilizing. Whether he has any critical editions of the Greek Septuagint, whether he has the Göttingen Septuagint, which is sort of the most extensive version of the Septuagint available today as far as textual critical material and things like that, because I don't know. But there is no question that ta tekna autu is different than tan huyan mu. This is, out of Egypt have I called his children, which would be, the him would be loved him, that's Israel, so I've called the children of Israel out of Egypt, is what is the idea of this form of the Greek Septuagint. But tan huyan mu is what's in the New Testament. So his whole idea is the Septuagint is corrupt. And the Septuagint that Matthew was quoting was different than the Septuagint we have today. Well, this, of course, begs the issue of what is the Septuagint we have today. It is very, very plain that the Septuagint was not translated by 70 scholars at one time. They all went into their caves and came back out with the exact same translation, and therefore this was God's demonstration. Though lots of Christians believe that was the case. A lot of Christians in the early centuries, from the 2nd to the 5th centuries, maybe even beyond that, did believe that story and did place inspired weight, maybe we term I could use, in the Greek Septuagint. And hence, I've mentioned before, the riot that broke out in Carthage when Jerome's Vulgate was read publicly. Had to change some of the wording between that and the Greek Septuagint, and people just found that horrific. I use that as an illustration of how a text can become a standardized text. So the Septuagint became a standardized text. Then it was replaced by the Vulgate. When the Vulgate first comes out, there's resistance. But 1,100 years later, Erasmus being attacked for daring to question the readings of the Vulgate, which was once the new kid on the block. So what Anderson demonstrates here is that there is a variant in the Greek Septuagint, which surprises absolutely positively no one who understands anything about Septuagint studies. But what he didn't recognize is if he had gone into the Göttingen Greek Septuagint, I have the apparatus open here, and down here at the bottom, you will see a little alpha with a prime, sort of like a cute accent next to it. But you see the line after it, Tan Huion Mu. Tan Huion Mu. So this is Aquila. This is Aquila's reading of the Greek Septuagint. Aquila's reading of the Greek Septuagint is the same as the New Testament renders it. Symmachus's reading is Huios Mu. And Theodotion is Huion Mu, which is just the article different than what you have over here. So two versions of the Septuagint have the accusative singular Huion with the genitive Mu, the possessive Mu. And one has Huios, which is the nominative Mu. And then others you have are Ta Tekna Autu, which is what we have in the printed edition, which is evidently what Anderson was referring to. What this shows us, remember, Anderson's a King James onlyist, strange King James onlyist anymore. Very, very unique in all ways. I mean, he will identify Ruckmanites as crazy people, and so they identify him as crazy people. And the infighting, this is what IFB folks are really all about. They like to fight with each other. But he's different. He's really hard to nail down. Most of your King James only folks are not reading Greek and Hebrew. I mean, he showed a good basic level knowledge there, just reading, you know, like anyone in first year Greek or Hebrew would be able to read the letters and pronounce them properly and so on and so forth. Recognize what's going on with it. And he proves that there's a textual variant. What he didn't go into is there is no single Septuagint. The Septuagint itself has multiple streams of transmission, just as the Masoretic scribes had to make textual critical decisions in the 9th century to come up with their extremely stable text. And there were multiple Hebrew streams in the days of Jesus as well, which is why we have variants in such places as Hebrews chapter 8, where clearly there were Hebrew texts that had Baal, others that had Gaal, and you have Greek translations of both of those. So the interplay of the various traditions, and these are textual traditions, not traditions as in the Korban rule or something like that. There's a textual use of that term. Go back to the time of Christ himself. And that's a problem for King James only people, sometimes TR only people, is to deal with the reality that the New Testament writers recognized these things and dealt with these things themselves. So I wanted to, that was put out there last night, and I wanted to go, yeah, well, that doesn't actually prove anything, because here's evidence that you had multiple streams and that there was a stream of Greek that is behind at least two of the major early versions that include the Greek Septuagint that had my son, whether with the article or without the article. That was there.